Kernow Asset Management is joining us today. Dr. Christina Makris is Head of Client Development there at the company. So we're going to learn all about what you do, what the company stands for, and a bit more behind this sort of genesis of the company, if you like. So first of all, who is Kernow Asset Management, Christina? And a warm welcome to Proactive. A very good afternoon.
Thank you for having us. So great to share our story with you. Well, Kernow Asset Management, we're a boutique manager and we follow UK equities. We believe that there are interesting special situations and dislocations and opportunities there, given the way the market has moved. So we are contrarian by style, by philosophy, or even. And we're somewhere in between, you know, we found a space in between short-term quant traders and closet indexers. So that's the sort of top level. On the human side, Kernow Asset Management consists of me and my two colleagues, Alex Wood and Ed Hugo, who we came together. Alex and I used to work together, and then Ed and Alex worked together in another context. And we came together because we worked in bigger houses and bigger funds, and we decided, we learned a lot from those organizations, and we decided that we could do things our way. We had picked up enough, and we thought that we would be in a position to offer a partnership and bespoke fund management service to entrepreneurs and ultra high net worth individuals, family offices, very much clients that also, you know, started businesses just like us, clients who want to work in partnership with us, clients who want to be involved with us and have a relationship with us. So Kernow is the Cornish word for Cornwall. So everyone will know Kernow from Cornwall, especially this summer, because I'm sure everybody's going to be going there. And we're based in London, but we also have a presence in Cornwall. And again, Cornwall is, you know, beautiful. It's a lifestyle. It's a state of mind. It's a philosophy. You know, you can work really hard and play really hard in a beautiful setting, and we just wanted to create a fund and create a boutique that spoke to that mindset, to that philosophy. And we've now been going for over a year, and we work out of London. One colleague is in Cornwall, back and forth. And yeah, that's the Kernow story.
That sounds good. I'm glad to hear that Cornwall is a beautiful place, because I'm going there in June. So very much.
Yes, I think everybody is this year.
Absolutely right. In regards to your background, let's learn a little bit more about you, Christina.
Yeah. Okay. So, I mean, we're Kernow Asset Management. Cornwall is, you know, you can tell from my international school accent, I'm not British. Well, I am now, but I'm not originally from the UK. My background, I came to finance in an unusual way, but not that unusual if you hear my explanation. So I'm originally an academic, a philosopher by training. I'm very heavily involved in the arts. I collect art. You can see behind me. I've just written a book, actually, on art collections in restaurants around the world. So that will be published in July. And I, having been in academia, I started working for Cass Business School, and I got involved in research there with two professors who are pretty well known in the UK in fund research, Steve Thomas and Andrew Clare. So I started working with them on publishing white papers and doing proprietary research for industry. And I just thought it was very interesting to, you know, this is when all the passive versus active debates were beginning. And it was just such an interesting time, I think, in finance, and an opportunity for, you know, creativity and finding new ways and mixing and matching and smart beta and all of that. So I eventually shifted. I retrained, left academia. I joined a family office, a a multifamily office in the UK. So I worked very closely with private clients, high net worth individuals, intergenerational wealth. So again, very close to the action and very close to the mindset of those types of investors. And again, it kind of nicely comes together because, of course, a lot of those types of clients are also clients who are interested in, you know, philanthropy, the arts, which I'm quite involved in. So it comes for a full circle. So then I met Alex in a different fund that I was working in, and he told me that he was starting up his own thing. And, you know, he said, do you want to come and join? And do you want to come and be in our team? And I said, yeah, I could definitely, I would love to do that. I would love to work closely with the clients directly. There's really something very, very exciting and creative to be, you know, entrepreneurial, to have skin in the game, to be able to, you know, build something. I mean, again, because I'm artistic, I think of it as a creative enterprise. So everything we do, from our branding, from the way we think, from the, you know, from what we do with our clients, where we take them to art exhibitions, we talk to them about things beyond the portfolio and beyond the investment. Because I think when you work, in my experience, having worked in the family office world and in the private client world, it's quite interesting because you get a lot of professionals, finance professionals, who have crossed over from different careers. I've met chefs who then went into private wealth. I've met army people that have gone into so it's quite, because I think high net worth clients want, private clients want individuals. They want people who have had life experiences and understand. And it comes to, you know, it's very complementary. It comes together very nicely. So that's my unusual background into this.
You don't often hear the combination of the arts and the finance world colliding, which they do very much personified by you. So lovely to meet you, Dr. Christina Makris from Kernow Asset Management here on Proactive London today, Head of Client Development there.